Hey Canucks fans, welcome to Clay's Canucks Commentary for Tuesday, November the 13th. I'm Clay Emo at Canuck Clay on Twitter, I'm at Clayton Emo on Instagram. I'm a founding member of the GLCPC, the Good Looking Canucks Positivity Club, and this is my Canucks take, all in one take. Last night, the Vancouver Canucks lost in Madison Square Garden. They lost to the Rangers 2-1, and that drops them on this four-game road trip to a record of 1-1-2. So that's still 4 points in four games, 4 points out of a possible eight. And they may sneak out a win tonight in New York. The New York Islanders, they're playing in Brooklyn against the Islanders. And then they finish off their road trip against Minnesota, a top 10 team. So you think they can still salvage or make it a 500 road trip by perhaps beating the Islanders tonight. And I think the Minnesota game is going to be very tough later on this week. But who knows? We shall see. You never know with this Canucks team. A scrappy team that is battling without six of their regulars, as we know. It's crazy when you look at it. That Brock Besser, Sven Berchi, Brandon Sutter, Jay Beagle, Alex Edler, and Anders Nielsen all out, one-third of their roster. So for the Canucks to be still maintaining a very slim lead atop the Pacific Division, it's still very, very impressive. And I'm not waiting for the wheels to fall off. I'm not hoping that they do poorly, of course. I think they're doing very well, especially considering all the injuries that they're playing through. They're much better, much deeper, much more able to play through injuries as opposed to last season. Last night, Nikolai Khudobin with a lone Canucks goal. Pedersen played pretty well on his 20th birthday, not his best game ever, but he still had his chances, both from a goal and assist standpoint. The two Rangers goals, one on the power play off a rebound, the other one kind of a fluky or lucky goal, really quick off the faceoff. The first shot was blocked, so Markstrom was still reacting to that shot, and the second one went past him. Delzato had a chance to score, a rare post crossbar post play that would have been awesome, would have given the Canucks a lead. And then also I put on Twitter a little fun little video about Troy Stetcher. In the fight that Archibald got into, you see Stetcher in the span of 4 seconds, he definitely cleared the puck, three gloves and two sticks away, to make sure obviously that the two players engaging in the fight didn't trip on anything or get hurt that way. It just, every hockey player does that, any smart player, any player that's been around for a while. But I thought that it was beautiful that the camera caught it, and I thought it was a little cute little moment. So I put it up on Twitter, got over 5,000 views. It's not about the views, but I think people like those kind of little goofy things, and I was able to capture it while watching the game. Okay, enough about my Twitter habits. Let's talk about the defense. Not Troy Stetcher, although I just talked about him. I want to talk about Derek Pouliot. And Harpsema actually inspired this video when he tweeted me early this morning saying, "What's your opinion on Pouliot? He is not sold." Or he hasn't an opinion. Well, I'll put it this way, Harpsema. I am not sold. I'm not sold on Pouliot. There's a reason why we only gave him a one-year contract at $1.1 million, basically a show-me contract saying, the team can walk away from it at the end of the season if he doesn't do well, or if he plays very well, the team can then sign him and negotiate with him and try and sign him to extension. Pouliot's game is very polarizing. It's kind of frustrating. He has a lot of tools there. Obviously, he's a good skater. His puck vision, his vision of the ice is okay. His hockey IQ, I just think it's okay. And his defensive play is just okay. So I had three okays right there. That's kind of how I feel about him. And a lot of people will point to his inefficiency on the power play pointing to him, the Pouliot detractors. And you do look at the power play, it has struggled. I know in the last 10 games, I saw Jeff Patterson put out a stat that it's only 14%. I know in the last four games, it's only at 12%, because going backwards, they went 0-4 yesterday. They were 0-4 against Buffalo. Then they did okay against Boston. They went 2-5, but, everyone was scoring against Boston. And then they were 0-3 before that in Detroit. So on this road trip, they're only 2-16, which works out to about 12%. 2-16 is not great. And then I get that it's not just power play one. Power play two obviously factors in it. You need more chances than maybe 16 chances in four games. That's not bad. That's about obviously an average of four per game. So that's not bad. But I heard Travis Green say after the game that he wants even more power play chances, which makes sense. We all want that. But I don't think you can pin the blame on the power play's poor performance strictly on Derek Pouliot, because we got to remember that Pouliot's replacing Edler, yes. But then he's got no Brock Besser and he's got no Sven Berchi. And those two are regulars. When our power play one was strong right at the start of the year, when everyone was healthy, it was Pedersen, Horvat, Besser, the big three, Berchi and Edler. Well, there's no Edler, there's no Berchi, and there's no Besser. It's only Pedersen and Horvat and some combination of Virtanen, Eriksson, Gaudette, Khudobin, whoever it may be, and then a point man. So it's not Derek Pouliot's fault. But Having said that, it's also Derek Pouliot hasn't done much to actually enhance the power play. You know, I don't think he makes the quickest decisions nor the best decisions up top. Although, to be fair, it's not like he keeps giving away the puck. But, you know, maybe he's a little predictable. You know, it's either to Pedersen or maybe a shot through. Oh, that's kind of funny when I say it. I just don't, the power play doesn't look dangerous. It looks predictable. It looks stale. And not just because of Pouliot, but Pouliot is considered the power play quarterback. Now, maybe that has a lot to do with the one side where he doesn't have a Brock Besser to give it to. So there's really no threat out there, no matter who you put there, Virtanen or Godolabin or Eriksson. Maybe there's not a threat there. Maybe his only option is either put a puck on net or give it to Pedersen on the right wall. But whatever it may be, the power play looks stale. There doesn't look to be a lot of movement. They sometimes even have trouble gaining the zone. And that has a lot to do with the power play quarterback. Although oftentimes, as you see many teams, like many teams, the blue liner will bring it from behind the net and then drop it back to a one or two trailing forwards with a back pass because the forwards are the ones that have speed. But Pouliot's still got to be able to navigate that as well. So overall, I think that's where you really notice. I would love to see Troy Stetcher get a chance on power play one. I would love to see Ben Hutton get a chance on power play one. Both of those two guys are playing with more confidence. I think they're just as good as skaters as Pouliot, and I think both of them are playing better and have a higher hockey IQ than Pouliot does. I'm not saying Pouliot's not smart, but I am saying that I think Stetcher, the way he can hold the line, Hutton, the way he's able to, you know, try things and play with confidence right now, and just simply a tiny bit of a bigger body than Pouliot. I'd love to see Hutton and or Stetcher get a chance on power play one. And then you can still have Pouliot on power play two, and you still give him his minutes if he needs them. So that's one thought about the power play. Yes, it's not Pouliot's complete fault, but he is missing Besser and Berchi from that unit. But still, as a quarterback, you got to be able to navigate, facilitate, and initiate and make things happen. On the defensive side, he's just okay. A lot of times, you know, when he's playing, he doesn't make the quickest decisions behind the net. Remember, two or three weeks ago, there were two or three straight games where he had a bad gaffe or bad giveaway that led to an opposition goal, and all those giveaways happen starting from behind the net. So that's the thing. I'm not sure about his vision, right? You know, when they reset and he stands behind the net and he looks around and sees all the forwards skating around and ready to cycle out. I'm not sure that Pouliot's making the best choices when it comes to breakout passes or when to skate it out. You know, it hasn't really bit us in the butt, so to speak, in the last couple weeks. So this is kind of a minor detail, but I'm talking about Derek Pouliot. I'm trying to analyze his game overall, and I just think he's meh. I just think he's okay. He's not the cleanest when it comes to breakout passes or skating it out. Doesn't always make the best decisions. And on offense, I think he can do more. He's only got 3 points so far, one goal and two assists in the 19 games. And he's a plus three. And then his possession stats, I'm not a big advanced stats guy, but I understand them. I looked at them very quickly before recording this video. They're okay. His Corsi and so forth are 50-51%. So he's right in the middle of the road when it comes to possession. Not too good, not too bad. Kind of middle of the road on the team. So that's my quick take on Derek Pouliot. I think he's okay. I think he'd be serviceable. But I definitely think on the power play, there's potential to put a Stetcher or a Hutton there. It'd be very interesting to see if they go to that, especially if Edler's going to be out for a longer period of time. So that's really it for today. I want to know what you think, Canucks fans. What do you think of Derek Pouliot's game? What do you like about him? What do you don't like about him? Do you agree or disagree with anything I said? Is there anything I'm missing that would help paint a better picture of the Canucks defenseman? Leave a comment below. I love to read, react, and reply as always. Subscribe to the channel if you like to. Like this video if you like to. And enjoy tonight's game, Vancouver versus the New York Islanders, game 5 of their 6-game road trip. Have a great day. God bless, and go Canucks, go.